So hello, everyone, and thank you for joining us. And first, I want to thank Heather Berry again for inviting us to do this session. And to Zhao and Samina, also really a warm thank you both for organizing this. And then thank you to all presenters and discussants for sharing their work and for reviewing the papers. And before I introduce them, let me just mention a few points on logistics. So to our virtual audience, please mute yourself during the session. And please make use of the chat feature. So write any comments or questions you may have. And when you write them, please put who the comment is for, either by putting the presenter's name or the number of the paper, for example, paper number one, and then your question. And then when we get to the end, we will direct as many questions as we can to the presenters. And the chat will be saved, and then we can share them with authors. So we will greatly appreciate your feedback and thoughts. And our session will have three parts. First, we will have four presentations, back-to-back 10 minutes. And then this will be followed by 40 minutes for our discussants commenting on the paper. And then we have some time at the end for Q&A. For the presenters and discussants, at the two-minute mark, I will unmute myself and then let you know that you have 2 minutes left. So to briefly introduce the presenters of this symposium, Arkadiy Sakhartov from the University of Illinois, Haijun Park from Penn State University, Christopher Sabe from Norwegian Business Schools, and then we are very honored to have three discussants, renowned experts in our field, Andrew Shipilov from INSEAD, Tim Folta from the University of Connecticut, and Will Mitchell from the University of Toronto. And now, without further ado, I'll pass the floor to Arkadiy Sakhartov, who will speak about resource redeployment in corporate acquisitions, going beyond horizontal acquisitions. Please, Arkadiy, you can start sharing your screen.
Hello, I'm Arkadiy Sakhartov, and I'm presenting a new study co-authored with Jeff Reuer and titled Resource Redeployment and Corporate Acquisitions. Resource redeployment is often defined as the reallocation of a firm's resources A to another industry or B to another firm. The two dimensions in which resources are redeployed motivated the two respective streams of research. On the one hand, withdrawal of a firm's resources from one industry and their redeployment to another industry within the same firm represents intertemporal economies of scope. Determinants and impacts of such economies were modeled theoretically and tested empirically. On the other hand, the withdrawal of resources from one party in a merger and their reallocation to another party in the deal that operates in the exact same industry was studied in research on horizontal acquisitions. Except for a few studies that implied redeployment in non-horizontal acquisitions but did not directly register such redeployment, the two dimensions of redeployment have been considered separately from each other. Meanwhile, business press presents some anecdotal evidence that acquiring firms combine the two dimensions by redeploying resources of targets to new industries. For example, Bombardier acquired Rotax, the firm that had previously built engines for Bombardier snowmobiles, and then redeployed the manufacturing plants of Rotax to the production of city trams. Furthermore, the phenomenon of acqui-hiring was exemplified with how Facebook and Google acquire firms, often from other industries, to subsequently redeploy those firms' human capital to new ventures at Facebook and Google. Finally, some nascent empirical research collected cross-industry samples that track employee mobility in corporate acquisitions, thus starting to focus on redeployment of labor following non-horizontal acquisitions. Responding to the nascent empirical interest in redeployment of resources following non-horizontal acquisitions, and to the lack of theory on resource redeployment in such deals, we aim to build a theory of redeployment that would more fully capture its properties. We do so by combining features of both dimensions of redeployment and by considering redeployment of resources between merging firms that may not be necessarily from the same industry. Accounts of important features of redeployment between industries date back to the seminal work by Edith Penrose, who classified such features into inducements and obstacles. Regarding the obstacles, Montgomery and Wernerfeld elaborated that relatedness between the industry from which the firm withdraws resources and the industry to which it redeploys the resources reduces the cost of such redeployment. In turn, our recent study with Tim Folta operationalized inducements for resource redeployment with the current return advantage in the recipient industry, volatility of returns in the origin and the destination, and correlation of these returns. Essential features of resource redeployment between the merging firms are based on stages of the M&A process identified by Choudhury and Tabrizi and the respective challenges. At the current stage of our project, we focus on the last two challenges. The first challenge we consider is the risk of adverse selection with which the acquirer is incompletely informed about the target and without undertaking due diligence can buy a lemon. The second challenge we focus on is linked to the integration of the target. If not facilitated by an integrative effort by the buyer, resource redeployment between the merging firms can be very costly and can generate inferior performance. We use a formal model to build a more comprehensive theory of redeployment. Like in previous models of redeployment, the evolution of returns in considered two businesses is modeled with the geometric Brownian motion. This model assumes that uncertain returns are more difficult to forecast the further an evaluator projects into the future. The specification also involves the three ramifications of inducements that were raised in previous research: the current return advantage, return volatility, and return correlation. Of course, in the context of our industry, I and J are industries in which the target and the acquirer respectively operate before the deal. They may not be necessarily the same industry. Without loss of generality, assume that the target's resources are redeployed to the acquirer. If we denote as omega I the proportion of the target's resources, the net cash flow the merged firm generates at the time of redeployment is this. This term in this statement is the cash flow the firm earns with resources staying in the target's business. This term is the cash flow the firm generates with resources that are used in the acquirer business. This term is the total redeployment cost modeled as a product of the marginal redeployment cost of a unit of resources, inversely capturing relatedness between the target and the acquirer, the amount of resources redeployed, and the current margin in the recipient acquirer's business to show the loss inefficiency relative to resources that were always deployed in that business. The valuation and the integration challenges are both linked to the marginal redeployment cost and are endogenously resolved by the acquirer with a decline in marginal utility of the effort of such resolutions. Thus, with the valuation challenges, the acquirer faces ambiguity about the redeployment cost and exert some effort to reduce that ambiguity. In turn, with integration challenges, the acquirer knows the redeployment cost and commits some effort to directly reduce this cost. Let me now show some results. There are two groups of results that are based on the respective challenges in M&As. In those results, the horizontal axis will represent relatedness that exogenously reduces the redeployment cost, because redeployment of resources between more similar businesses is naturally less costly. For each of the two challenges, three field counter maps are created to show the three ramifications of inducements: the current return advantage in the recipient business, volatilities of returns in the merging firms, and return correlation that are all placed along the vertical axis in the respective plots. The key difference of the six graphs from previous accounts of redeployment in horizontal acquisitions is that these graphs go beyond the marginal case. The target and the acquirer are from the same industry and which represent only the right margin of these six plots. Besides that, we allow the acquirer and the target to be from different industries, adds the three additional predictors of the merger and acquisition performance. So what are the key takeaways from these formal results? We believe that we offer a nuanced account of how resource redeployment involved in M&As affects value realized by acquirers. Our account is not restricted to the case of horizontal acquisitions. The marginal case where the acquirer and the target come from the exact same industry may miss the context where resource redeployment creates most value. Redeployment of resources between strongly related merging firms adds more value than redeployment of resources when the merging firms are from the exact same industry. Thus, U-shaped relationship between the merger and acquisition return and relatedness. Besides, we establish that regardless of the considered M&A challenge, volatility of returns in the merging firms monotonically increases the acquirer returns. Also, regardless of the considered M&A challenge, correlation of returns between the target and the acquirer monotonically decreases the acquirer returns. Finally, with the valuation challenge, the acquirer return has an inverse U-shaped relationship with the current return advantage in the destination for redeployment. In contrast, with the integration challenge, the acquirer return monotonically increases the current return advantage. We hope that those results will lay the groundwork for future empirical estimations in corporate strategy research and for better decision-making by corporate acquirers. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Arkadiy. Really interesting work.